Hello friends, myself Dr. Vivek Kumar Jain, Assistant Professor in Physics, Department of Science, Biyani Girls College, Jaipur. I am here to present a wonderful topic, Michelson Interferometer. Before starting this topic, we generally introduce the term interference. What is interference? Interference is the phenomena when two waves or of same frequency, same amplitude, moving in a same direction are superimposed, then the intensity is redistributed. It is maximum at some point and minimum at other points. So this redistribution of intensity is known as interference of light. So we see the very examples in our daily life, light, soap bubbles and thin film between the air and the oils are the different examples of interference. Okay, so one is device we use the measure the interference, which is Michelson interferometer. So we discuss about the Michelson interferometer. Here the diagram of the Michelson interferometer arrangement. A source of light is used, and in front of this source a convex lens is used to parallel the light beam. Here a plate is around 45 degree angle is placed, which is semi-silvered glass plate. This plate works as a beam splitter plate. It divides the ray into two parts. One is reflected part and second one is a transparent part. This is the reflected part and this will be the transparent part. These are the mirror M1 and M2. From reflecting these mirror, the rays meet at the point A and the fringes, interference fringes observed in the telescope T. Okay. So, the principle of this interferometer is based on the division of wavefront, division of amplitude method. Since we know that the coherent source will be required to interference, and there are two different methods, division of wavefront and division of amplitude method. So this is the example of division of amplitude method. In this there will be two rays which is reflected partially and partially transmitted. These two rays are the known as coherent sources. So they meet at the point A and the fringes are observed in the telescope T. Okay. So this will be the construction of the Michelson interferometer. Now this Michelson interferometer is used because we have to find the wavelength, refractive index. So this P is a beam splitter plate and the plate C is known as compensating glass plate. If we remove this compensatory glass plate, then the ray 1 will be passed this plate 2 times. So the optical path difference of ray 1 and ray 2 in the absence of compensatory plate is not same. So to equate the path difference between ray 1 and ray 2, we use the same material and same thickness as and parallel to the plate P. So this is known as compensatory glass plate. So these are the construction and principle of the Michelson interferometer. Now here we describe the how the fringes are formed, formation of fringes. The fringes are formed due to the mirror M1 and M2 rays. Here the image of M2 will be reflected in the side of mirror M1, which is known as M2 rays. So the thin air film between the mirror M1 and M2 rays will be the formed. This will be the thin film formed between the two mirrors. If we place a source in front of this, this is the source which is placed in front of these mirrors. So the distance between this is x and the distance between here, which is d. So the total distance between mirror M2 dash and source will be the x plus d, and the distance between here, which will be the x, and this will be the x plus d distance. Okay. So the image of this source will be made behind the mirrors. These are the images of this one S1 dash, and this will be the S2 dash. So the distance of S1 from mirror, which will be the x, and this will be the again distance between the mirror M2 dash is x plus d. So if we see from here, this is the telescope and light comes from here. Then these two rays are coming from the same direction, which is behind the mirror S1 dash and S2 dash. Now if we draw a perpendicular from here, this part difference will be the same, and this distance will be equal to the twice of d, because the distance between mirror is d and the part difference between two rays will be the twice of d. Okay. So if the angle of this light will be here theta, so this will be the 2d cos theta. So part difference which will be equal to the 2d cos theta in the Michelson interferometer. If we use the bright fringe condition, so for bright fringe the part difference will be n lambda, so this will be equal to 2d cos theta. And for dark fringe, it will be equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2. So these are the condition of bright and dark fringe in the interference of Michelson interferometer. So on the condition of this part difference, there will be two types of fringes we observed. First is circular fringes and second will be localized fringes. Circular fringes are also known as non-localized fringes. The condition for this is will be the M1 and M2 are exactly perpendicular. These mirror are M1 and M2 is perpendicular mirror, or M1 is parallel to M2 dash, then we observe the circular type of fringes. If the mirror M1 is fixed and M2 dash image of M2 mirror will be crossing the mirror M1, then there will be localized fringes observed. First, if they cross each other, then straight line fringes observed, and they are supposed to cross to each other, then hyperbolic fringes we observed. So these are the formation of fringes. Different fringes are observed in the Michelson interferometer. So these are the imaginary source S1 dash and S2 dash due to the mirror M1 and M2 dash. So these fringes are the fringes of equal inclination. These circular rings also known as fringes of equal inclination, because the angle between these rings will be the same for the formation of fringes. If we see here, this will be the telescope and the angle for this ring will be the theta here. Same angle will be here theta, and this will be also theta from here, from theta. So the locus of all points having the same angle theta, we give the fringe nth order fringe. So these are known as fringes of equal inclination also. So this is complete about the Michelson interferometer. First we see the how the Michelson interferometer work, and we see the different types of interference fringes observed in the Michelson interferometer due to the path difference between two mirrors. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Please like, comment and share this video.